5,000 subscribers. Let's go. What is happening, guys? Martin Martinez back again. Estamos aquí para hablar sobre cuatro perfumes que me gusta. Vamos a hacerlo ahora. Vamos. Okay, guys, I'm touching base with you in respect to four fragrances. Had a little bit of time out about now, just have a bit of a break. And again, you can see it's getting to Christmas time. Hopefully someone's gonna help me sort of like do this tree struggling right about now, but it is what it is, guys. Anyway, so four fragrances came out. This is obviously from the house of Paco Rabanne. These guys are killing it, they're doing their thing. And I mean, this whole sort of 1 million saga started off in 2008 and now we're up to 2020. Now there's one in my collection I don't actually have. I think it's 1 million cologne. It wasn't really, some people say it's quite a good one. I've not had enough experience with it to really know. However, when it comes to 1 million, we're doing okay. Four bottles I think is pretty sufficient. So rating from 1 to 4 that I have in my collection, which one is counting from 4 to 1 all the way to 1. So number 4 for me, guys, on the list comes in this particular one right about here. Hopefully you can see that one on the screen. And this is the 1 million lucky version. Guys, came out in 2018. 2018, this one came out. Now I've got a 50ml bottle. Again, at the time it came out, I got it when it was out in its first week. This one to me, guys, everyone knows about 1 million. It's sort of the original version anyway. It came out in 2008. This is 2018. You know, they talk about this bubblegum sort of vibe, a little bit childish and everything else like that. This one to me, guys, in my opinion, it's got a very deep, prominent plum note in there. And I think that's what sort of puts me off a little bit. A bit of, I don't know. Some people it'll work for, some people definitely get the compliments. They'll definitely enjoy this one. In my opinion, this is probably like a more of an all-rounder type of fragrance. It could potentially be for the party. It potentially could be also just for the evening, chilling out, even date night to some extent. Some people really think, you know, this is probably one of the better releases. Now, my personal opinion, for me, this is number 4 on my list because for some reason, the plum note in there just smells a little bit annoying to me. I don't know why. It's like one of those fragrances that when you have it on, you're feeling like, I've got this on, it's okay, but it's not necessarily my favorite fragrance. It's just a fragrance that I have on because I feel like wearing it just for today. Fragrances that is okay, really, and that's all I can say about it. The plum note is all that I pick up on. Not really much more. I know there's different note breakdowns and different note breakdown when it comes to this type of fragrance. At the end of the day, guys, for me, number 4 on my list, it just doesn't quite work for me, and that's why I only have a 50ml bottle. These are the sort of fragrances, guys, that I personally, I pick them up, I get them when they come out, but I won't necessarily, how could I say, I wouldn't go out my way to go and buy a full 100ml bottle if I didn't like it. And I think with 1 million fragrances or Paco Rabanne for fragrances, you do pretty well with a 50ml bottle anyway, because a lot of the time the projection is well into 8 hours plus. So I was quite happy with this one, guys. As I say, projection-wise, easily 8 hours. You do get your scent trail, you do get your bubble, but it just smells a little bit annoying to me. Maybe for me, this is a little bit juvenile for what I would like as a fragrance, but I can see this more as maybe a sporty, casual type of fragrance compared to obviously 1 million with that bubblegum vibe. This one seems to be a little more chilled out. It's definitely still got a 1 million DNA, but at the same time, this one takes it in a slightly different direction. Again, I'm gonna keep saying plum because that's the prominent note that comes to me. But it doesn't smell like, it smells like an overly sweet plum. It doesn't smell like a sort of like nice, freshly warmed type of summer plum, I could say. I'm getting like even hints of like a honey in there as well. A little bit too much sort of syrupy for me. So I don't want to say sickly, but for me, it's just a little bit too sweet for my liking, this particular type of fragrance at this point in time. So this was 2018, guys, when this one came out. To work out for number 3, you know, we've got these two here. You've got this one here, 1 million Privé. Hopefully that comes up on that. You can see with my 50ml bottle. And then equally, we've got this one here as well that came out not too long ago. And this is 1 million Parfum. So there's a little bit of a difference here, guys. So for me, again, counting down, I'm a little bit indecisive. I'm not quite sure where to go with it. I'm gonna go with this one. Oh yeah, guys, before we get into it, please do not forget to leave your comments down below. Please don't forget to comment and subscribe, guys. Some of you guys, you're watching the videos, subscribe to the channel. Leave your comments. Let's help build it up with the algorithm. So for me, guys, number 3 at my 4 fragrances, and this one came out in 2020, believe it or not, and it is this one here. This is 1 million Parfum. I'm gonna go and say that this one for me, on all honesty, is my number 3 in the list. The 1 million DNA is still there. You do get an element of that sweetness. You do get an element of that sort of, I don't say bubblegum note, not everyone picks up on that, but it's that type of candy type of smell. But at the same time, this one is sweet, this one's slightly lighter, it's not as dense, a little bit more, borderline sort of, how could I say, got ambergris note there, ambroxy note there, salty note there, sea salt sort of smell going on, solar notes apparently for this one as well. Nice fragrance, guys, but for me, this is number 3 on my list. It's one of those fragrances, as I say, you can only probably wear it around summertime. Projection is still fantastic, longevity is still good. For perfume concentration, as I say, this is actually good for 1 million. These fragrances actually should not be scoffed at, but at the same time, you know, for me, it's just a case of when would I wear this and what would I do with it. And ultimately for me, guys, it's going to be ones, again, that I go for sometimes. It's one of those fragrances I go for sometimes, but not all the time. And at the same time now, right about now, had this one probably around about earlier part of the year when it came out. It's definitely going to be in my collection. Would I buy another bottle of it? Probably not. For me personally, because I've had experience of it, and there's so many other fragrances out there. But for what it is though, guys, not bad if you get this one on sale. That's number 3 on my list. Numero 2. We're here with this, guys, and this is the one and only 1 million Privé. Hopefully that comes up on the camera so you can see it. This is one of those bad boys, guys. This is one of the ones that will last, and this will last easily 8 hours again. Not a problem whatsoever. Funny enough, actually, just looking at this one, this is actually all the parfum concentration. So this isn't even the parfum concentration in the last one that we just talked about. This is the older parfum. So it's crazy how they did an EDT, and this one happens to be the older parfum. And again, it's still giving me the longevity, guys. This is a very nice fragrance. You got this type of tobacco note in there. I personally want to say like an incense note in there. But it's definitely one of those fragrances which is more seductive, more of a winter fragrance. Nice type of, I don't know if it, even to say if it's like a frankincense note in there, guys. This is a well-blended fragrance. Some people talk about this type of maybe, how could I say, like a blood orange type of note going on as well in the opening part of it. I mean, I can even spray this one now for you guys. I mean, beast mode performance. This is a fantastic fragrance. Nice opening, zesty opening. Again, it's a little bit bitter, like a, as I say, blood orange, like a bitter orange type of note, or maybe like a mandarin note. Fantastic type of fragrance, guys. Again, it just so happens to be from the house of Paco Rabanne. Again, and these guys are doing what they need to do. Some people may look down on this fragrance, but for me though, guys, this is one of those fragrances that I would highly recommend. Fantastic. And for what it does, I think it's one of those fragrances that makes me think to myself, you know what, this is a winter jacket type of fragrance. Easily wear this one, probably, as I say, going out if you're doing anything outside, outdoors. Nice fragrance, guys. This one will cut through the cold. The difference with this fragrance, obviously, it's not necessarily a one-size-fits-all type of fragrance. It's not one of those fragrances that I think you could really wear to a clubbing environment, anything else like that, because it might be a little bit too heavy. But for what it is though, guys, 50 mil. I think I actually got this one on sale as well. I think I just purchased this one not too long ago, probably around about £35 or so. 50 mil is not bad. Would I buy a 100 mil bottle? Probably not for me. I've got too many fragrances now where I think I go through too much. But what it is though, guys, fantastic fragrance, guys. That's Numa. Why am I speaking in Numa? Yes. This one came out in 2016. Can you believe it, guys? 2016, you know, they're killing it, man. They're killing it. Again, you can pull it off, in my opinion, in most situations, but more so in winter time. Definitely a nice winter fragrance, guys. And let's get into it, guys. Numero uno, this is number one, guys. This is the one on the list, which again, some of you guys may not agree with. And if you don't agree with me, that's fine. Leave your comments down below and tell me why you don't agree. But at the end of the day, guys, this is one of the ones that started it off. This is one that's got so many compliments. So many people know about it. Again, I think it's pretty cheap for what it is now, £45. Shouldn't be paying anything more than that. And this is the only one that came out in 2008, guys. This one started it all off, it seems. And it was this one here, guys, as you can see. The original Don Dada. This is the original one, guys. The original one, guys, that came in. And this is 1 million, the original. This is the EDT version. Yes. No, EDT. Yes, it is EDT. Yes, it has been reformulated. Don't worry about that. It's been reformulated. That's how it goes, you know. Since 2008 to where we are now. I mean, hey, is that a big deal? This one is still giving you beast mode performance, long-lasting fragrance. Probably one of the better long-lasting fragrances, I would say, from a designer house. When it comes to especially buying outside of niche brands, this is probably one of the best ones out there, in my opinion. Easily 8 hours, probably into at least probably like 12 hours plus. Put this on your clothes, you smell it for a good 24 hours the next day. So many women like this fragrance, guys. So many people know about it, and maybe that's the sort of, how could I say, It's apparently in the UK, this and Dior Sauvage are the two best selling fragrances in the UK. Can't talk about other places. Even when I went to Germany, this was like so used up in Germany. So many people told me they love this one in Germany. So if you're from Germany, you let me know. Is this something that everyone wears in Germany? If not, let me know down below. But ultimately, guys, this is one of those fragrances which I will say, in my opinion, is still number one. Yes, I give it the respect. I give it respect where it's due. You can say, oh, well, it's childish and everything else like that. But it started off the whole ball game. And for my fragrances in my collection, this is number one. From one to four, this is definitely number one. Fantastic fragrance, guys. Very cheap, long lasting. Again, clubbing banger. You can wear this non-stop. Can't necessarily wear, I personally wouldn't wear this to an office environment, but at the same time, you can wear this easily for social, easily for your walks out, doing what you need to do. But if obviously in a working environment, it might be a little bit too loud, a little bit too party-ish, maybe a little bit too childish for some. But at the same time, guys, this is one of those fragrances which is still a staple. I keep always a bottle on deck because I never know when I'll feel like wearing it. Fantastic fragrance, guys. Really enjoy this fragrance. And hopefully I'll save you some time and some money. You know, these fragrance reviews, again, they're very good, but I do want to try and expand the channel. As I keep saying before, we will get into fashion and we'll talk about some fashion points. Even this hoodie, got this one from Zara at some point, but hey, there's other things we can do. TK Maxx, we'll talk about TK Maxx as well. And hopefully, guys, I'll see you on the next video very shortly. Ciao.